Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are discussing here question number 391 to 400. This is the part 22nd of top 400 MCQ of Code of Criminal Procedure. This is the final video of this video series. Now, question number 391. On completion of investigation, the officer in charge of police station shall forward the police report under section 173 subsection 2 of CRPC to option A here, session court, option B here, chief judicial magistrate, option C here, any judicial magistrate, option D here, magistrate empowered to take cognizance of an offense. So in this question, answer is here option B, the police report forwarded by the police officer to the magistrate. Question number 392. When a trial court releases an accused on bail under section 389 subsection 3 of CRPC after conviction, the accused on bail and imprisonment not exceeding 3 years, option B, accused on bail and imprisonment not exceeding 5 years, option C, accused on bail and imprisonment not exceeding 7 years, option D here, when offense is exclusively bailable, whether accused is on bail or not. So in this question, answer is here option A, when the accused on bail, the imprisonment is not exceeding 3 years. In this question, when the court is satisfied where a such person is being on bail or sentenced to imprison for the term not exceeding 3 years. So in such condition, the court may grant a bail. And where the offense of such person has convicted is a bailable or one and is on bail. In these conditions, the accused is released on bail. Question number 393. The mark the incorrect statement. The complaint means any allegation made by orally or in writing to the magistrate or officer in charge of police station. Option B. An inquiry into an offense may end in discharge or conviction. Option C. Bailable offense mean an offense which is shown as bailable in second schedule of the code, option D, all of the above. So in this question, all the statements are wrong here. So answer is here option D. Now we are discussing here first statement. The complaint means any allegation made orally. Yes, it is correct thing. In writing, it is also correct to the magistrate. This sentence is correct in this point, but or officer in charge of police station. No, officer in charge of police station, the complaint is not before him. So this option is wrong here. Now come to the point B. The inquiry into offense may end in discharge or conviction. It is wrong here. Option B here. The bailable offense means an offense which is shown as bailable in second schedule. This point is wrong here. This is first, F-I-R-S-T, first schedule of the code. So all these options are wrong here. Now answer is here option D. Question number 394. A charge is framed by option A, police in the charge sheet filed under section 173, option B, by court, the court, option C, the court with the assistance of prosecution, option D, the court with the assistance of prosecution and defense. So in this question, the charge is framed by the court, option B, and this thing is provided under section 211. Now question number 395. The criminal procedure is a matter in the dash list of the 7th schedule of the Constitution. So In seventh schedule, there are three lists. First one is union list, second one is state list, and third one is concurrent list. So there is no residuary list. So union list, a list where the central government makes the law. There is a matters and or a subject, and upon the central government makes the law in union list. But in state list, in this list, mainly the law makes by this state government, except provision is in the constitution where the emergency or the state government request to central government to make a law in state government state list. Otherwise, the power of making a law in this list is by state. Now come to the point here, concurrent list. In this list, the state government and central government both having a power to make a law. But when the contradiction between the central, the law makes by central and state, the central law is prevail over the state law. This is the law of the Pitts and Substance law. So in this question, CRPC is the matter in the concurrent list, option C, of the 7th schedule to the Constitution of India. So CRPC here is under a concurrent list, the both central and states making a law. Question number 396. The boy aged about 16 years is suspected to be involved in the commission of an offense of murder. So murder defined in 300 of IPC, and its punishment is 302. And he can made to join investigation at the police station, at his residence, at any place of his choice. Option D here, either A, B, or C. In this question, the age of the boy is 16 years, who is suspected to involve in the offense of murder. So this question is related to a section 160 of CRPC, where the boy whose age is under 15 years, the police officer taking an investigation at his home or any place on his choice, but not in police station. But in this question, the age of boys is 16 years. That's why he can made to join investigation at the police station. So answer is here, option A. Now question number 397. Under section 200, the recording of pre-summoning evidence may be dispensed with if. So first of all, we are discuss here which thing is provided under section 200. Section 200 provided that examination of complainant, who take the examination taken by the magistrate. So such examination taken by magistrate. Who take a cognizance of the complaint, which is given by the complainant, and on oath. This is very important. So magistrate take an examination of complainant on oath. So here, examination of complainant oblique witness. Whose witness? Complainant's witness. So witness is also examined here, and such examination shall be recorded by the magistrate and with his sign. But following persons are exempted to examine if they are made a complaint before a magistrate. So which persons are exempted? So option A here. So point A here, not option, point one here. If public servant make a complaint, so he is exempted. There is no need to examination of public servant, and who dispose of his duty during made such complaint. And second person is there, magistrate who makes trial oblique inquiry to another magistrate under section, to another magistrate under section 192. So these two persons magistrate need not to examine, except all other persons are examined who made complaint before a magistrate on oath. Now come to the point here. Option A, the complaint is supported by an affidavit of complainant. Option B, the complaint is made in writing by a public servant. This is important point. Public servant acting in the discharge of his official duty. Option C, the magistrate feels that the end of justice will be served by dispensing with pre-summoning evidence. Option D, all of the above. Now again I read here question. Under section 200, recording of pre-summoning evidence may be dispensed if, so we are cleared here already, if the public if complaint is made in writing by a public servant acting in the discharge of his duty. Two persons are there who is dispensed to examination of by the complainant, by magistrate. First one is public servant and second one is magistrate who is conducting a trial or inquiry to another magistrate under section 192. So answer is here option B. Now question number 398. A non-confessional statement recorded under section 164 is, first of all, this is important here, it is non-confessional statement. Option A is a substantive evidence. Option B is a not substantive evidence. Option C can only be used to contradict the testimony in the court. Option D, both B and C. So in this question, answer is here option B, D, both B and C. It is not a substantive evidence. And option C here, it can only use for contradicting a person who giving a such statement in the court or the testimony in the court. So question number 399. For the purpose of computation of period of 90 days or 60 days as the case may be, under section 167 subsection 2, option A here, the day of arrest. So here day of arrest of accused has to be excluded. Option B here, the day on which the accused was remanded is to be excluded. Option C, the day of arrest of the accused and the day on which he was remanded, if the different both have to be excluded. Option D, the day of the arrest of accused only has to be excluded and the day on which he was remanded, even if different, cannot be excluded. In this question, answer is here option C, the day of the accused, the day of arrest of accused and the day of he was remanded, if different, both they are different, so both have to be excluded. Now question number 400. Option where a case relate two or more more offenses of which at least one is cognizable and other one is non-cognizable, the case shall be deemed to be a cognizable case. Option B, the case shall be deemed to be a non-cognizable case. Option C, either A, B, and depending on the discretion of the magistrate. Option D, either A, B, depending on the fact and circumstance. First of all, this provision, this thing is provided that in the section 155 subsection 4, in this section provided that where the case is related to a two or more offense of which at least one is cognizable and the case shall be deemed to be cognizable case. So according to this section, section 155 subsection 4, answer of this question is option A, where the case is related to a two or more offense at least one is cognizable and another non-cognizable, so the case shall be deemed to be cognizable case. So answer is here option A. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching.